friends, how's it going? It's me, Betty Jean. Today we're just gonna sit back and chat about my favorite things for the month of August. Mostly makeup, tiny bit of fashion, you know how it goes. I talked about it in my favorite Netflix shows video, but I think I wanna start doing my more organic backdrop here in the game room for videos that I'm not putting on makeup, so that includes favorite videos, so let me know how you feel about that. I like it, so I'll probably keep it. I don't wanna ramble too long, let's just jump right in. The first thing I wanna talk about is my only skincare item. It is the one that I got in my Orglamic subscription box, the Superfruit Under Eye Serum. It's a very oily consistency. I love using this under my eyes at night. My eyes feel so hydrated in the morning. My makeup has been laying really good on my under eyes lately. I haven't been getting any kind of cakey or weirdness happening, and the only thing I've changed is using that at night, so I'm really into that. Next, I have a couple eyeshadow palettes to talk about. First, I have the Anastasia Norvina palette. It is such a good palette. I love Anastasia's shadows, and this palette is no exception. I feel like even though it is purple based, it's not too purple. I think you can create a lot of really cool looks with it. I already did a 3 looks, 1 palette and a first impressions video using this, so I will try to remember to link those down below. Really into this palette. You can create some really beautiful looks with it. The other palette I want to talk about is the ColourPop Kathleen Lights, the Zodiac palette. It looks like this. It is absolutely gorgeous. I am super happy with this palette. Again, I have also done a 3 looks, 1 palette video and a first impressions using this. I will try to remember to link those down below as well. As I said in my 3 looks, 1 palette, the only one that I don't love is this blue because it's a little lackluster. It takes a lot to build it up, but it's not a bad palette. It's very affordable and I'm super into it. Sticking with ColourPop, next I have the ColourPop and Kathleen Lights part of the Zodiac collection. This is the What's Your Sign Luxe Lipstick. It is a really pretty nude. I love it a lot. I feel like this flatters a lot of different looks and would flatter a lot of different skin tones. It's not too pink and it's not too warm and it's not too cool. It's just a really perfect nude for me, honestly, and I love the Luxe Lipstick formula from ColourPop. I have the Dose of Colors Bury Me Liquid Lipstick. I've had this for a long time, but I haven't really worn it until recently. By the time this video goes up, I will have had my hair dyed for about 2.5 weeks or so probably. And I started wearing this lipstick soon after I dyed it. It's what I'm wearing right now. It just matches so perfectly. I love this berry color with my hair. I never thought I was a berry lipstick kind of person, but apparently I am. I love the way it looks and I love that it matches my hair. I just have one more product from ColourPop. It is the ColourPop Flexitarian Highlighter. I've talked about this before. I think this was in a favorites video at the beginning of the year. I just want to talk about it again because I've kind of re-fallen in love with it. Not that I ever fell out of love with it, I was just using other things. But guys, it's just so good. It's what I'm wearing on my face. It's pretty much what I've been wearing on my face all month. It is so bright, it's so pretty. It blends into the skin so nice and it just leaves my skin looking so wet and glowy, and I'm totally obsessed with this. Last makeup product, I have the CoverFX Custom Enhancer Drops in the shade Sun Kissed. I talked about this in a video. I think it was a Get Ready With Me, I don't really know. But basically, I got this for free from BoxyCharm because I referred a friend during a certain week, so each of us got one of these. So it can't be used as a highlight at all. But I do find that if I put a little in my bronzer areas of my face and blend it out, it makes a really pretty glowy bronzer color on my fair skin. So it actually worked out really well and it blends so pretty, and powder bronzer layers really well over top of it. Moving into fashion, I wanna talk about this cute choker that I'm wearing. It's this cute little sparkly bat necklace that I got from Palace of Glitter. I've talked about them before. I do have a code, ButeBean, if you want to save 10% off of your purchase. I think I'm actually getting another order from her today or tomorrow with some cute Halloween things that she's come out with. I love so many of the things she's coming out with. She makes really cool earrings and chokers and necklaces. So if you wanna give a small brand some love, then I would check out Palace of Glitter. She has really awesome stuff. I just have one more thing to talk about, and I meant to talk about it in last month, but I totally forgot. But I just wanted to give another shout out to the Smile Brilliant Teeth Whitening Kit. I did a full, very in-depth video and demo using the product. Helped make my teeth nice and white, and I'm super happy with my results. I felt so much better about my smile. I smile more in pictures with my teeth ever since using this. I have my custom fitted trays. I have my whitening gel and my desensitizing gel, and I just absolutely love this product. This is another one that I do have a discount code and referral link. They will be down below, but it is ButeBean. You get 20% off your purchase. So I guess that's it. This was probably a really quick monthly favorites video. I just kind of spent a lot of time doing 3 looks, 1 palette videos with ones I already had and the 2 palettes that I talked about today. So I didn't try too many new eyeshadows, and my face routine has pretty much stayed the same. The only things I really did that were new was the Custom Enhancer Drops Bronzer, and I've reintroduced the Flexitarian Highlight into my life. I didn't buy too much new makeup this month because I bought so much new makeup in the month of July, so I was just taking it easy this month. But these are the things that I was loving in the month of August. Please let me know what you were loving, whether it is makeup or skincare or fashion or food or anything like that. If you enjoy these monthly favorites videos, please give it a thumbs up. It helps me out a lot. I really like making these. If you're not already, please hop over to my Instagram. It's BeautBean. Follow me there. I post every single day. And don't forget to subscribe here before you leave. I post every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Let me know what videos you want to see on my channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Okay, bye. Here's Absol. He wants to hang out today, apparently. Let's just lay down.